Hello and welcome! My name is Eva and today I'm going to talk to you about my favorite and most used products of 2020. Right now I can tell you that this video might be long, so grab something to eat or drink, your favorite tea, coffee, water, what you want, and let's hang out for a while. Before I start, a few disclaimers and informations. My last year, so my favorite and most used products of 2019, you can find, of course, here. And down below in the description box, I'm going to list products that I'm going to show you today. And next to the product, I'm going to add link to my video where I show you this product first time with swatches, close-ups and everything. Now, disclaimer, the most important one. If by any chance something that I was talking about on my channel that is fantastic, I love it and etc. will not appear on this video, it doesn't mean I don't like it or that I lied in that video. No, it's just I had to choose the best of the best. So when I had, for example, a few palettes that I really, really love. And side note, every palette that I have, I love. When I don't love something, I get rid of it. So I love every single palette that I have. So when I had a few my favorite palettes, I choose those ones that I use the most. That's why I say my favorite, but also the most used. And because these are products that are favorites of the year, the previous year, that means there's a lot of them. So I don't want to talk and be here with you for ages. That's why I'm going to make it as quick as possible, shortly, without a lot of informations. All you need will be in those listed videos down below. So in videos with review, first impression, final thoughts, just videos that are about this product. This is just collective video with these products. I don't have any PRs, so everything that I'm going to show you I bought myself with my money, and some of these products not exactly launched in 2020, so it's a mix. Some of them are new on the market and some not, but they are my favorites, so I'm going to show you. I think it's a good idea to show you just my favorite products and not exactly the newest favorite products. No, just favorite. So I'm going to start with face, so base, foundation, contouring, then brows, eyes, lips, and some other stuff, like for example tools. So let's start with base. So what is under my foundation? And as my base, I'm using, I know, funny, Nivea for Men Sensitive Aftershave Balm. I just love it. I've used it, not this bottle, but this product for 5 years maybe. And I really see the difference between using it or not using it. It's a little bit sticky, but it's moisturizing, so it's nice. My makeup stays longer with this product under my makeup. I had some samples of other bases. I even have a full product of one base from well-known brand. And to be honest, if there is no difference, why overpay? So this is my perfect under makeup base. Next, of course, is foundation. Last year I showed you Fenty Beauty, but matte profiled foundation. And this year I have also Profiltr, but hydrating formula. Oh yes, I have a little amount of this foundation and I really like it. There are some differences between this foundation and matte one, and I have a video about it. I love the shade because it's my perfect shade, 100, finally perfect shade for me. After I use the rest of it, I'm going to use this one and matte one in the same time. I'm not sure yet if I'm going to mix them or maybe use hydrating formula on the center of my face and matte on sides. Not sure yet, but for sure there will be video. NYX concealers, and also I was talking about them last year, and these are Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define. They have good coverage, they are cheap, they have a pretty big spectrum of colors, so that's also nice. I use C0.2 under my eyes, C1 on my pimples. I have also white one, so it is C0, and I use it for cut crease. Another concealer that was also mentioned last year is by Inglo, AMC cream concealer, and this is number 60, green one. This is the best green concealer I've used. It's absolutely perfect for any blemishes, for any redness, pimples, and I even like to use it without any other makeup product. If you blend it correctly, you shouldn't see it on your face. This color is amazing, formula is good, so I believe that other colors also should be good, but I haven't tried them, so I only recommend you this green one. Next are powders, also mentioned last year. So Kryolan Anti Shine, this is rice powder. This is very, very matte powder. If you have oily skin or mix combined skin, but with a lot of oiliness here, this is like super powder. Imagine very, very matte powder. This is savior. I had very oily skin and I've used it a lot. Now my skin changed a little bit, so now I use it a lot less, but still I love it very much. And also this is 30 grams, so it's a huge amount of powder. It's amazing. I love it. Very good powder. And next one is KVD Vegan Beauty Locket Translucent Powder. And I use this powder under my eye or when I have very, very dry skin, because it's very, I would say, soft powder. It's not super matte. It is matte, but it's not super matte. It's more like it gives you this matte finish, but in the same time with a little luminous effect. It's not highlighter, it's not like very shining effect. It's something like I have here, because today I use it here. So here you have matte, like true matte, and here you have, you can see that here is matte, but it's a little bit like, you see that it catches a little bit light. So that's why it's perfect under your eyes, because you don't want to have here a lot of matte finish. You want something that a little bit catches light and it's just soft in a way. Very good powder. So let's go to contouring, and starting from bronzers. Again, product that was already mentioned last year. It's KVD Vegan Beauty Shade and Light Contour Palette. And you can for sure tell that this is my favorite palette. Good palette. I like the shades, all of them. I even used the darkest one in small amount, but I used it. To be honest, I don't use as much these light shades, but these three are absolutely amazing. And I love this palette very, very much. And probably when I'll finish it, maybe I'll buy those just single shades, because I saw that you can do it. So maybe I'll do it, but there is still a lot of product here. So yeah, very good palette. Next, I have new products. So from 2020. And these are Skin Bronzing by Nabla. I have all four shades, and I love all four of them. With a brush that imitates natural hair, or brush with natural hair, it depends if you like vegan brushes or not. These bronzers are just amazing. I am afraid that I'm going to drop them, so I will show you them like this. So I have all four shades. Of course, these two are the darkest ones, but I used all of them. Of course, this one in very small amount, but this one, neutral, I would say even that it's a little bit cool toned, but for sure it's the most coolest shade in this collection, let's say. So it's very good for contouring. These two are super as bronzers. This biscuit one, might be very good for contouring if you're very, very light. As natural contouring, for me, remember, Fenty 100, it's very pretty shade. However, I like obvious contouring. That's why I don't use it as true contouring, maybe more for bronzing. I like to build my contouring and bronzing effect with all four of them. Oh, they are very smooth and pigmented, and oh, colors are so natural, and I love them very much. Very, very good. Of course, I have review with those bronzers. So of course you can find it down below in the description box. Next is something that also I've already showed you last year, and it's Golden Rose Mineral Terracotta Powder in the shade 4. And this is my blush when I don't know what blush I want to use. Of course it's not a blush, it's bronzer, it's luminous bronzer, and you can see in pan that it is a little luminous, but it's not highlighter. No, 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 no. It's just luminous bronzer. I've used it a lot on my channel, so maybe you recognize this product. It matches to a lot of makeups. I would say even that it matches to every single makeup, especially when I don't know what blush I want to use. So very nice product. I love it and I use it a lot. Next are products actually from the last year, so something new. And these are KVD Everlasting Blushes. This is Snapdragon and this is Rosebud. So actually I have two of the darkest shades and also I have video with them. From my notes, it seems that Rosebud I used a lot. They are very creamy. There is a little fallout in pan, but if you know KVD products, then you know that there is this little dust in palettes. So if you don't mind, these blushes are absolutely for you. They are very beautiful, very pigmented. You can build them, of course. And this one I like very much with dark lipsticks. And this, it's a little bit lilac shade. Oh, it matches to so many makeups. They are so, so beautiful. So from blushes, we're going smoothly into highlighters, but not so fast, because first I have to show you another Nabla product, which is skin glazing, and I have some of them. First, you can see Ozone, which is highlighter, which I love, absolutely, very gorgeous shade. And I was talking about this shade last year, but I have some new shades, which is Truth, that is highlighter, but I use it as a blush because I am so pale that it's too dark for me. Skin Glazing Lola, which is blush, very nice one, very nice one blush. Of course I have video with it. Next one, Independence. Also I have video with this very gorgeous blush. It's a little bit cool toned, a little bit walnut shade, so it also matched to many makeups. Very good shade. And the last one is Adults Only, so beautiful ruby shade. Actually it's highlighter, but of course not for my skin tone, so I use it as blush. What can I say about this product in general? Not only shades, but product. Very, very good. Very, very good. And yes, I'm ready for more. I'm very curious what Nabla will release this year. Next, to my surprise, I haven't talked about it. KVD Alchemist Holographic Palette and Alchemist Holographic Transformer. These products are discontinued, so if you find them somewhere, for example on KVD vegan beauty website, grab them, because they are absolutely amazing. This big palette is actually a palette of highlighters, but I like to use them as touch of color into highlighter on lips. Oh, stunning. This is more like, I would say topper. Well, these are also toppers, but this is more like topper because it has a lot of little sparkles, and it has transparent base. If you find those products, if they are available somewhere, I really recommend to buy them. And yes, I've bought this and this to have in stock. So these are products that I use, but also I have in my drawer this and this unopened in case. That's how I love this product. Let's finish highlighter category with BPerfect and Stacy Marie Get Wet highlighters. Of course, Get Wet. So all four of them are very pretty, however some of them I used more. I'll show you of course every single one. So this is Soft Silk Gold one. Unfortunately a little bit too dark for me, but very, very good as a body highlight. And if you're not as pale as me, you'll love it because, like I said, Fenty 100, alright? So it's not like this Soft Silk is so dark. No, I am so pale. If you're not as pale, probably you're going to love it. Next one is Hollow Glaze, pinkish one. Very nice, it's not too dark on my skin. My favorite ones. So Dewy and Skin Sheen. This is Dewy and this is Skin Sheen. This is very nice, like champagne beige shade. And this one, gold and blue particles, but together, of course, they look a little bit greenish, but I love it. I love it very much. Very good highlighters. You should apply them with damp sponge, and you can do it on already done base of your face. So you can use damp sponge with those highlighters on your powder, which is amazing. And by the way, this is Stacy's technique. Two products for brows, and also I was talking about them last year, so only quick. KVD Super Brow Pomade. I have shade dark brown, and oh, this is very good pomade. Of course I have it right now on my brows. It takes its time to dry out. So it's not like it will be dry after a few months of using. No, you have to wait a little bit longer, a lot longer, and then it will start to dry out. If it will start to dry, you can just take a tissue, swipe this surface of this pomade, and under this surface is absolutely great, smooth, not dry pomade. Very good product. I like it, and I have one in stock in my drawer also. And next one is of course Brow Styling Gel by Golden Rose. I showed it last year. I use it every day. Maybe not every day. Not every day I do my makeup. So now let's talk about eyes, and I have some things here. Of course, let's start with base, which is, yes, P. Louise base, my favorite base. And believe me, it changed my makeup routine. I had a lot of issues with my creasing eyeshadows, and this base is eye makeup savior. If you have issues with creasing, with durability of your eye makeup, try this one. I don't even want to think about what will happen if there will be lack of this base on market. I want this base to stay with us forever. Next one, eyeliner, also mentioned last year, so KVD Tattoo Liner. KVD Vegan Beauty. Tattoo Liner. I've heard that Fenty Liner is better, but I haven't tried it. Of course, here we have brush, not sponge, and I like when tip of eyeliner is brush. And of course it's waterproof. This is very, very good eyeliner, and also I have some in stock. That's why I can't for now check Fenty. And also I don't use eyeliner as much. I have love-hate relationship with eyeliner. Now new product, so from the last year. And these are Cupid's Arrow, of course, by Nabla. So multiple use stylo. There's four of them, for now. These launched with Cutie collection, so with the newest Cutie palettes. Of course, I have video with them, but also I have video with this black one. And actually, this black one is this color that I use the most. But I love all four of them. They are very good. Of course, on the here on the back, there is a sharpener, so everything is on point with this product. And I test it in every single way. So as my under eye shadow base, on my waterline, today I used this one. On my waterline, I have it right now. As lipsticks, I even use them as lipsticks and they are amazing. I use them as eyeliners and they are also amazing. Very good product. I believe I even use them to a little bit add some color to my brow. So yes, you can use it as you wish, as a lip liner, lipstick, on waterline, eyeliner, eye base. So many possibilities. Now let's talk about palettes, because I have plenty of them here. And because I have a lot of favorite palettes. Also those ones that I mentioned in video from the last year. Maybe not every single one, but for example Dreamy 2 or XL Proc. So I won't talk about them today. But let's start. First is BPerfect and Stacy Marie. Carnival Free Love Tahiti palette. Of course. Oh, I waited for this palette and I waited. I really waited for true tropical palette. And when I say true, I mean true tropical palette. So with a lot of warm tone shades like jungle green, something that will remind me about beach, jungle, mango juice, something like this. And this is palette, perfect palette. Of course, we have here so many different shades and so many possibilities. And of course, with XL Pro, these two make so great couple. A lot of shades that are very similar to Subculture, but of course with better formula. I have a lot of videos with this palette, so of course some of them are, or for sure the first one will be down below in the description box. And I used a lot. I don't know what to say, because I feel like I said enough in those videos before. This is just very good palette and I very much like it, love it. Next one is something very fresh, but I think that it should be in today's video. And this is Unicorn Cosmetics Wicked palette. Launched in 2020, at the end of October, if I remember correctly. Of course, I have videos with this palette. In my opinion, this is very good goth palette. Very good. It doesn't have so much vibrant shades, like very neon obvious shades, but it has a lot of colors. Swampy green, ink blue, and this creativity in names. I was talking about this palette so much that I don't even know what to say here. It's just a very good palette and it's a very good replacement for KVD Vegan Beauty Signed and Sinner. So I would even say that it's better because it doesn't have as many neutral shades, which is pretty good. This palette contains everything that metalhead or goth would like to have in palette. Black, grey, purples, swampy greens, a little bit neutral shades, but not so many, some pastel shades. So we have here a lot of possibilities and makeup for every season, believe me. So very good palette. I haven't used it a lot because it's still pretty fresh palette, but I feel like it should be in today's favorites. So it is. Another pretty fresh palette is, of course, Side by Side Nude Palette. So palette by Nabla. When I saw it, I don't like nudes. Really, I don't like nudes, but when I saw this palette, this neutral to cool toned palette, I was like, oh yes, finally. Finally something for people that not exactly want to wear sun scent on their eyelids every single day. And by the way, this palette with Cutie Platinum, oh, it's a perfect match. Just perfect match. And I love this palette very, very much. I use it actually a lot, even though it's very fresh palette, but I use it already a lot. What can I say? I very much recommend this palette because it's good. Of course, the same formula as always, Nabla keep their standards. So matte formula is on point. Shimmers are absolutely amazing, like fluid metals. Oh, just gorgeous, gorgeous palette. And of course, I have a lot of videos with this palette too. Next one, or next ones, are Cutie palettes. Of course they are. So also last year launch, three of them, three new cuties. Of course I like those first two, but we are talking about these three: Platinum, Metropolitan and Wildberry. Beautiful, 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 beautiful palettes, but my favorite is Platinum. It's obvious that it will be Platinum. I love Metropolitan and Wildberry, but Platinum is the best of the best. The formula in all those three is the same. It's very good, but just this color story is my color story. So I love it. I love it very much. Here you have Metropolitan with beautiful tree frond, by the way, very beautiful, and this fluid. Oh. And Wildberry, very nice shade with sister to the OG Alchemy. This is Alchemy 2.0, so very similar, but it's a little bit different, has a little bit different undertones. If you like Alchemy, the OG one, this palette might be for you. Eyes are almost done, time for lashes. Unicorn Cosmetics lashes were my favorite, but of course I choose only those that I used the most. I'm going to show you those four types of lashes that were the most loved by me, but they don't look like new lashes, so just beware. And these are Forget Me Not, Peachy Pie, Cherry Top and Lemon Meringue. We're slowly getting to the end. So lips, first are Bullet Lipsticks by Nabla. I have three of them. I love every single one, but the most used one is shade Bugbeat. The same as last year. There are different finishes. Bugbeat is Soft Touch. And here I have also Foxy Lady and Lust. And these are Bounce Matte. So you need to check, for example, on Nabla's website, because these lipsticks has a little bit different finish. Love them, love them, love them very much. Still we're staying with Nabla, but this time with Glam Touch lipsticks. And these were launched with Cutie Collection. Platinum, Metropolitan, Wildberry. Three absolutely beautiful, amazing, gorgeous, with beautiful scent lipsticks. The Platinum one is Vanilla, Metropolitan is Coconut, and you can imagine how smells Wildberry. To my surprise, Metropolitan, so the most nude one, was the most used. How this happened? 2020 made me use nude lipsticks, and nude makeup in general. It's horrible. Let's stay with Nabla for a little bit longer. So, lip glosses. Shine Fairy lip glosses. Maybe you can already see which ones were my favorite. All of them. But the most used ones are Champagne Supernova. It's almost empty. Also Renaissance, somewhere here. And Toxic Love. It's also somewhere here. But this one is... This one is Balm. Of course, I love all of them, so I only showed you the most used ones, but I love all of them. They are very good. They are long-lasting. As for the lip gloss, beautiful colors, pretty pigmented, coconut scent. And also I have videos with them. Also, I have lip swatches of all of these lip glosses. All links down below, in the description box. The last product from Nabla. Finally, maybe let's... Oh no, not the last one. But the last one from lips. Nabla Liquid Lipstick. Dreamy Liquid Lipstick. Shade Vicious. I really regret that I couldn't bought full collection. This lipstick launched with Dreamy 2 palette. And recently I bought this lipstick. Oh, it's so good. It's not going to dry out on your lips because it's not matte, but it's so good lipstick. And this particular color is so beautiful. So I don't know what to say more about this lipstick than that this color rocks. The scent is amazing and it really looks beautiful on lips. Last two products, actually three, but two. KVD, both will be from KVD. First is KVD Vegan Beauty Vinyl Lip Cream, shade Lolita and shade Dahlia. Also, I have video with these two, and yes, Lolita was the most used shade. Oh well. Nice ones! This is what I can say. Nice ones. Longwear, they stay pretty long, beautiful colors, shine, on point. And the last lip product, but here I won't talk about the product in general, but more about shade. And this is KVD Vegan Beauty Everlasting Liquid Lipstick Shade Witches. I love everlasting liquid lipsticks, and I was talking about these lipsticks last year, but this color was the most used color last year. It's so funny that in fact when I saw my list, the most used color on my list was some nude shades and this black. That's why I had to show this black here, because this was almost... Actually, I believe this was the most used lipstick last year, because I used a lot of different lipsticks. Those that I showed you, and the one and only, the most used lipstick was, I believe, this one. Black is new nude. Finally, we can talk about some other stuff. So, the next product I'm going to show you is this what I have here. And this is Nabla Body Glow. So, body highlighter. It's a big shame that last year I haven't used it as much, because I was sitting at home. This is so good glow. I was afraid about the color, because the color is pretty dark. But this is how it looks like after blending on skin. Because here we have transparent base. And this, what you can see here, is very dense shimmer, which is now here. This is very good product, very good product. It has one advantage, that is also a disadvantage, is so long lasting, like so much, that it's hard to take it off. By the way, this is shade Sugar Babe. I can guarantee to you that it's waterproof, because one time I applied it, the same day I took shower, and the next day I saw that I am in this highlighter. So it is waterproof and shower gel proof. You can go swimming and still have this highlighter on your body. So I think that was the point. As always, last year also I had to, so this year also I had to recommend Meron's body paint. This is Paradise palette, the biggest one. As you can see that I used one black entirely and one almost two whites. Very good palette, very great paints. I just want to mention them here. And let's move on to the last stuff that I want to maybe not show you more, talk about it. And these are Nabla brushes. I don't want to take every single set because they are arranged in order in my drawer, so I don't want to take every single Nabla set, but I'm going to talk about them a little bit. So last year I showed you, not so long ago, three sets of brushes: aquamarine one and ruby one, and also there was amethyst one. I haven't used any brush from Amethyst set for this makeup, but I used two brushes from the new set. Probably you know that I love Nabla's brushes. I use them here for this makeup that I have now on my face. I used these five brushes. Also I used from two brushes from White Rose set, which is not available anymore on Nabla's website, but these sets are. So the Nude, Ruby, Aquamarine and Amethyst. But also I want to talk about my absolutely favorite two brushes that I discovered last year. I'm not sure if they launched last year or not, and I don't care. I just discovered them last year. And these are two brushes for powder, big powder brush and precision powder brush. And these two brushes absolutely changed my makeup routine. Before those brushes, I used powder puffs. You know, puffs are like sponges, so you have to throw them away eventually. You won't throw brushes, right? So I saved some money since I used those brushes, and I use them every single time I do my makeup. This big brush for my face, this small one under my eye, sometimes on my nose and forehead. Also this one I use when I, for example, apply too much blush or highlighter. So I can always rely on these two brushes, and I haven't thought that two powder brushes can change my routine so much. So this is my special shout out for these two brushes, but in general I love Nabla's brushes. Nabla's brushes are vegan, cruelty free, and they imitate natural hair. So we had here a lot of new stuff from 2020, but also stuff that launched in 2019 and even long before it. And I think that's good, because in video with favorites, I feel like we should show things that are in fact favorites and not only favorites that were launched in 2020. But this is my opinion. Let me know what was your favorite products this previous year. Of course, remember that down below in the description box you have a lot of informations with videos, with reviews, with swatches, with all that stuff, with these products that I showed you today. So don't forget to look down in the description box if you're interested in any of what I showed you. Don't forget also that this makeup is in previous video if you haven't seen that. So I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you get this far. So of course I'm waiting for your recommendations, for your favorite products, for the most used products. To be honest, I can't wait what Nabla will release this year, because obviously I love Nabla. So that will be it. I hear that I'm losing my voice. So as always, I love you very, very much, and I see you soon. Bye!